Hi everyone, and welcome to another season of More with the Mayor. It's so good to be back with you. And you know, we've had a lot going on the last few weeks. There was a nice turnout for my annual State of the City address. There, I was able to present many of the city's past accomplishments and show what's in store for Franklin's future while making some municipal magic in the process. A delegation from our German sister city, Bad Soden, was in town to make our partnership official with a formal signing event at the Eastern Flank. They spent an entire week learning the ins and outs of our community and even took in a polo match at Harlandsdale. Recently, Franklin went to the dogs. A public-private partnership with Mars Pet Care has made us the pilot city for their Better Cities for Pets program. More than 90 downtown businesses are welcoming our four-legged friends to shop indoors and also hang out on their Main Street patios. Speaking of dogs, did you know that pets lower blood pressure, reduce stress, and encourage being active? Becoming a healthier community is our topic today. And in a few minutes, we will be talking with Michael Acker at Healthways in Cool Springs. We'll discuss what it takes to be a healthy community. But first, we stepped out and made a healthy move of our own recently at the Walk More with the Mayor event for Get Fit Franklin and Healthier Tennessee. Let's check it out.
Franklin Tomorrow's Get Fit Franklin project is part of the Healthier Tennessee initiative. And one of the things that communities across Tennessee find is that when you walk with your leaders, such as with Mayor Ken Moore, you get more people involved and more interested in walking.
We are a healthy community compared to most communities in Tennessee. But compared to the nation, we're not all that healthy. I think it's important to highlight some of the health aspects of our community and things that we can do to not only make us feel better, but also a healthier workforce is more productive and saves money for our company.
So many of our teens today suffer from video games and couch potatoes, so we're stressing always to keep them physically fit, keep them healthy and actively involved in the community. And Mayor Moore is doing an excellent job, so we consider this a privilege and an opportunity.
We all had a great time on the walk, and I hope you'll look into joining us next time. When we come back, a closer look at Franklin's health. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
Good morning, Franklin. It's another beautiful day in the neighborhood. Local news is coming up next. We'll check the weather and the traffic. You have a great day.
want to say good evening, Franklin, Tennessee.
Welcome back. Today I'm in Cool Springs, Franklin, Tennessee, at Healthways, and with me is Michael Acker, who is the General Manager, U.S., for the Blue Zone projects all across America. And so Michael has his master's degree in public health, and we've had the opportunity to meet Michael a number of times, but never in front of the camera. So today we're going to talk about something that's special and dear to his heart, because that's how he gets paid, and it's through Blue Zones.
That's correct.
So first of all, before we talk about Blue Zones, let's talk about Healthways and how they fit into Franklin.
Sure. Well, Healthways is a well-being company. We've been around for a number of years, almost 30 years, and our mission as an organization is to create a healthier world, one person at a time. And last year, about July of last year, we were actually acquired by a company that's based out of Atlanta called ShareCare, a digital healthcare company founded by a man named Jeff Arnold. Actually, he created the company WebMD. And he was asked, you know, if you were to do that all over again, what would you do? And so their organization, ShareCare, got really interested in what we were doing, because as a high-tech company, they're really interested in our expertise around what we called high touch. We knew how to interact and help people manage disease and manage their health on a one-to-one basis. And so that's really what we've been up to and what we've been doing both here in Franklin and really across the world. We're an international company.
Well, you know, behind us are these books, Blue Zone.
Yep.
And probably many of our audience don't even know what a Blue Zone is.
Yeah.
So can you kind of talk about the concept of Blue Zone?
Sure.
And how Healthways is trying to implement Blue Zones in other places?
Absolutely. So as a company, Healthways, for a number of years, what we did was a one-to-one, meaning that our clinicians, our dietitians, our caregivers, they helped patients and members and individuals on a one-to-one basis. But we knew that as they went back into their community, back into their place of employment, they were being impacted by their environment, either positively or negatively. And we know that your environment has a tremendous impact on the choices that you make every day with respect to your health. And so that's where we found the work of Dan Buettner. Dan Buettner is a National Geographic fellow, author, explorer, journalist, photographer, and he was commissioned by Nat Geo to find the places in the world where people were living measurably longer than the rest of us, with a higher quality of life. He called these places Blue Zones. Places like Okinawa, Japan, Sardinia, Italy, Ikaria, Greece, and even one here in the United States, Loma Linda, California. And so Dan's work was to ultimately distill out what made these communities or these long-lived populations across the world similar to one another. What were those behavioral and environmental characteristics that could bring them all together? So how could we start to explain this exceptional longevity? He called these things the Power 9 principles, and they're pretty simple. They move naturally. People in the Blue Zones didn't exercise in a traditional sense. They didn't run marathons or triathlons. They tended to grow their own food in their gardens. They tended to walk to the store. Their homes were deconvenienced. They didn't have garage door openers. In Okinawa, they didn't even have chairs. They got up and down off the floor. They ate a diet that was different than we see here in the United States. About 80% less in terms of the caloric intake. Mostly a plant-based diet. They did eat meat, but they tended to treat it like a celebratory food, more like a condiment than the centerpiece of a meal. They all had a sense of, they all had this idea of purpose. In most of the Blue Zones, there wasn't even a word for retirement. We know that the two most dangerous years of your life, one, the year you're born, two, the year you retire. And rather, they had this thing they called in Okinawa, ikigai. It meant roughly translated to the reason I get out of bed in the morning. So they could all articulate their own personal mission and personal purpose. And they were really connected to one another. They kept their aging parents close by. They tended to have monogamous spousal relationships, and they tended to hang out with friends that were like-minded. And we know that health is as contagious as the common cold. And so if you have a strong social network and friends that are around you and supportive, that helps you to make better choices in your life. And so we took those Power 9 principles and ultimately with Dan and his organization created a model to bring out and test this grand hypothesis, which was, could these blue zones become a blueprint for better health in America? And we've been doing that over the last 6 years. We're in 42 communities today. We started in Albert Lea, Minnesota, but our work now ranges across 9 states, 42 communities, and there's roughly 3.3 million Americans today living in active Blue Zones demonstration communities across the country. So.
Well, let's talk about Franklin. You know, we were named by the governor as a healthier community, but based on your experience as director for Healthways Blue Zone Project, how's Franklin doing?
Well, I think Franklin and Williamson County as a whole has a lot to be proud of. I live in Franklin. I work in Franklin. We rank highly. In fact, we rank first in the state as a county and really as a city in many different aspects related to our health: obesity, smoking, nutrition, activity. We rank really highly as compared to the rest of the state. I think that's due to a number of things. We have great businesses here. We have great leadership here. The city works really, really well with the county. I travel the country, and that's not what you find everywhere else, and I think that's making a really big difference. And so there's a number of things that are going on in what I'd say, things are going right here. We're doing a lot, you're doing a lot in the built environment and built infrastructure, and I think we're growing smartly. And that's really important. But I think if you look down into the data, there's some areas of opportunity. Williamson County as a whole ranks really highly in stress and anxiety as compared to the rest of the state. And so I don't know exactly what that's from, but it might be due to the kind of jobs that we have in this community or the kind of commutes that are, you know, we have growing traffic issues as we go up to Nashville. But those kind of issues of stress, anxiety, depression are starting to express themselves in, you know, opioid issues and mental health issues as you look out across the rest of the county. I think Franklin's a really affluent community, but if you look at the county as a whole, there are some real disparities that tend to get hidden or overlooked if you just look at the data at a county level, just because of the concentration of affluence, wealth, and things that are happening in Franklin. But, I think while we have a ton to be proud of, ranking first in the state of Tennessee, Tennessee doesn't rank all that highly in these metrics as compared to the rest of the country. And so I don't think our work yet is done. And I think you've really shown that, you and your staff and this entire community said, you know, that being first in the state in a lot of these things really isn't good enough long term. It doesn't mean we can rest back. We have a lot yet that we still need to go do. So,
well, I appreciate you mentioning behavioral health, because that's been an important topic for both Chief Deb Faulkner, our police chief, and myself. And we've spoken often about the challenges of suicide in our community and other behavioral health issues, and I appreciate your bringing that to our attention. And certainly we'll continue to focus on that. You know, I'd like to maybe kind of tell you where we feel like our emphasis is and have you elaborate on that a little bit. But we think the groups that have come together, at least in Williamson County and Franklin to this point, have focused on four main areas: obesity, smoking cessation, activity, and behavioral health. So if you want to make some comments about any of those or trends that you see.
I think those are great focal areas. They are big issues today and have been for a while. I think things like smoking in this community, in this county, and really the country, have been going in the right direction over the last number of decades, but there's still a lot of work to do. As a well-being company, we like to look at the whole individual, not just the physical expression of disease. And so where we really focus our energy at the Blue Zones project is looking at those root causes. Why? What are the reasons why people end up with these things like obesity, or why do people end up with addiction issues in the first place? And really it comes down to the way that we do or don't connect with one another, the social support structures we have in our lives, our financial security. And so we're looking at those things from an environmental perspective at the Blue Zones Project, and we're looking at those from a policy perspective. So I'd say, I think your focus on those core areas are the right things to be addressing, and what we try to do is look at the root causes of those issues to really get at the long term, really make an impact on those over the long term. You know, in this country 30 years ago, the average American had three best friends that they could call on a good day or a bad day, and they'd actually listen. Today it's down to a friend and a half. Even with all the things out there to connect you to your social group through digital and technology channels, we're less connected than we've ever been. If you meet the technical definition of loneliness in this country, it's as dangerous to your health as a smoking habit. And so I would, if I could encourage any suggestion in the way that we go about tackling these as a community, is to really start to look at that from a social perspective. And I think there's already a ton of good things happening. You mentioned the walks that you're doing as a community. I think that more opportunities for people to come out and meet their neighbor are only going to help really address these things over the long term.
Well, thank you for being with us today for the interview and talking about Blue Zones. And, you know, Healthways is one of our main companies here in Cool Springs, and they not only give back by keeping us healthy with their Blue Zones and many of the ideas that they're sharing, but also the fact that they're a great corporate citizen that gives back to the community, and we appreciate them being here. So we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to be looking at one of the traditions of my wife and I. We always have Meatless Mondays, so I'm going to tease you with a recipe in just a minute.
What's the address of your emergency?
Well, it's not really an emergency. It's loud music.
Okay, hold just one moment. I'm going to try to a non-emergency number, okay, so we don't top a 911 line.
When it's not a life or death emergency, dial 794-2513.
794-2513.
Yes, 794-2513. My neighbor's music's too loud, you see. Dial 794-2513. 794-2513. That's 794-2513. Thank you. I dial 794-2513, and the Franklin police, they answered me. 794-2513. 794-2513. When it's not a life or death emergency, dial 794-2513. That's 794-2513.
What's the location of the emergency?
There's not an emergency. I need the non-emergency number.
And before we go, in the spirit of healthy living, how about a recipe from my home? My wife loves to cook, and one of our traditions is Meatless Monday. This dish is quick, easy, nutritious, and of course, delicious. One of our favorites is zucchini spaghetti with easy lentil marinara. It matches ingredients that not only provide a lot of important vitamins and nutrients, but also has a great zippy taste to it. I hope you enjoy that recipe. It's a favorite of mine and my wife's, and maybe you could start your own healthy tradition in your home. Well, that's all the time we have for this episode of More with the Mayor. We'll see you next time, and thanks for watching.